So this is a code walkthrough for the file MethodsMoreEfficient.java. Let's open this one up. This is pretty much the same as the previous example, except what we've done here is we have encapsulated the area calculations into their own dedicated method, calculateArea. And we'll find that method at the tail end of this file, right here. Okay, so this is an improvement, but we can see that there's still a certain amount of repetition in this file, and it's still a candidate for some improvement. So let's compile this file and run through it. Let's run through it free running first, and that's what we'll get out. And now let's do the same thing, but let's set a breakpoint here on main, and I want to demonstrate something that's kind of useful. Actually, it's really useful with the debugger. We're going to go ahead and single step through this code, and we're going to set up all the radii, and notice that here we're single stepping through each of these calculate area calls and returning an area, as seen here. Now, I was using the down arrow to do that, but when I have a method call like this in a piece of code, I can also click this bent arrow and it's going to drill down into this method. So watch what happens when we click this bent arrow instead. Now we're here on line 35, but if we click this bent arrow, all of a sudden we've shifted down into this calculate area method, and now we're inside here stepping our way through this method, and we're calculating the area inside the method and we're returning it to the caller. So this calculated area is going to get passed back to this area 4 where it's being calculated. So watch what happens here. I've jumped back to where I was calling it. Let's do the same thing. We'll call calculate area again using radius 5, and again we leap down to calculate area and we can step through here. We've calculated an area based on that radius, and now we're going to give it back to where we were before. So this method call here returns a double value, which means that this entire expression on the right-hand side reduces to one double value that's set equal to area 5. And this is a really nice capability of the debugger, letting us step through and drill down into lower level methods like this. I strongly, strongly suggest that you try this out for yourself and get familiar and comfortable with the use of the debugger in this way.